Hello everyone, my name is Sophie Van Meyel and today I'm going to present you a study on the effect of gut microbiota alteration on maternal care in the European airway. Gut microbiota consisting of a community of microorganisms residing within the gut of almost all animals. This gut microbiota has impact on many different aspects of their host life, such as physiology, reproduction and behavior. Whereas, recent studies revealed that, in addition to these multiple effects, gut microbiota may also shape host sociality. For example, in family-living rats and leaf-cutting ants, an alteration of the gut microbiota community leads respectively to an increase in social avoidance and a higher level of aggressiveness towards conspecifics. But despite this apparent impact of gut microbial communities on their host sociality, its effect on parental care remains experimentally unexplored. However, parental care is a phenomenon present across all the animal kingdom, which has important impact on the fitness of both juveniles and parents. And shedding light a link between gut microbiota and the expression of parental care can provide crucial information about the early evolution of complex animal societies. Then, we therefore wanted to experimentally explore the role of the gut microbiota on the expression of parental care. To do so, we used the European earwig Forficula auricularia, where females express extensive and complex care towards their eggs and their nymph. To alter the gut microbiota of mother earwig, we used rifampicin, a broad-spectrum antibiotic largely used in insects. We thus had two treatments, mothers fed with rifampicin and mothers fed with water. Just before egg laying, we confirmed that the antibiotherapy altered the bacterial community by performing gut extraction and DNA analysis on 10 individuals per treatment. Then we studied whether this gut microbiota alteration had an effect on the expression of 4 maternal egg care and on 2 maternal nymph care. You can see our results on the 4 measure maternal egg care. On the first graph, we recorded the duration taken by mothers to clean their eggs. On the second graph, you can see a female exploring an arena after being separated from their eggs, and the ordinate axis corresponding to the percentage of exploration by the female. On the bottom left graph, we measure egg defense by mimicking an attack of a predator with repeated physical stimulation, called poke, and we recorded the number of pokes that must be given before the female abandons her eggs. And finally, you can see egg abandonment, which is the time it takes for the female to return to their eggs after being chased away. As you can see, the earwig mothers express similar levels of egg grooming, egg searching, clutch defense, and egg abandonment, whether they have been treated with water or antibiotic. Concerning the impact of treatment on maternal nymph care, we measured 2 forms of maternal care. First, the nymph's defense, expressed as for the defense of eggs by recording the number of pokes. And second, the nymph abandonment, which is the time it takes for the females to return to their juveniles after being chased away. Again, our results show that treatment with rifampicin does not alter the expression of maternal care towards their nymph. Overall, despite that gut microbiota shape the expression of host sociality in numerous species, our findings provide the first experimental evidence that alteration of gut microbial communities using rifampicin did not impair the expression of maternal care in the European earwig. However, gut microbial communities consisting of a broad diversity of microorganisms that could have key role in host biology and maybe are non-sensitive to rifampicin. Therefore, future studies will be required to test if no other members of the gut microbiota shape maternal care in our species. Finally, we cannot rule out hypotheses that adapted strains which manipulated host sociality never occurred within the gut microbiome of our species, or that competition among microbiota members have prevented the emergence of host social manipulation. I would like to thank my collaborators who worked on this project and the lab in which I was able to carry out my PhD project. Thank you for your attention and enjoy the rest of the conference.